ॐ ब्रह्मणि ब्रह्म शक्त्यांश्च अभेद परमार्थता तथापि करुणाकारा शारदा ज्ञानदायिनी जननीं शारदां देवीं रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयो श्रित्वा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहु। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे इज द हैप्पीएस्ट डे ऑफ माय लाइफ। आई हैव टू स्पीक ऑन द डियरेस्ट पर्सन पॉसिबल इन दिस वर्ल्ड, नॉट फॉर मी बट फॉर एवरीवन, एंड दैट इज व्हाट वी कॉल द होली मदर, the Sarada Devi, Shri Sarada Devi. And to judge any person, to evaluate any person, to know really any person, we must find its character. What is the character of that person? And to know the character of any person, we must know what is his consciousness, what is the inner bodha. That is, makes the whole difference between a person and a person. We call him God and Devi and Deva and what not. But the difference between a person and person is the inner knowledge which that person has, what we call the bodha, the consciousness, awareness. And about this, I straight away start with an incident where a sannyasi, a young sannyasi, approaches Shri Sarada Devi and asks her point blank, "What are we to you, O Mother?" Expecting that she will call him, "Oh, my child, my son, you are all dear son to me," an affectionate term. That is what he was expecting in the mind. And he asked, "O Mother, what are we to you?" And spontaneously came the reply without a moment's notice, "You are Brahman, my child, you are Brahman." He was taken aback because he thought he will get an answer that you are my child. Then he asked, "Are we not your children, Mother?" Mother said, "You may be my children, but you are Brahman." Spontaneously this reply came. And that determines a person. A person has the eternal Brahma consciousness about the whole world, definitely about himself or herself also. That cannot be accepted. So that is the main consciousness we must understand. To judge a person, we must know what is the innermost reality, what is the innermost consciousness of that person. And we all know that she used to treat all of us as children and all that. But when asked point blank, "What are we to you?" she replied, "You are Brahman, my child, you are Brahman." "Are we not your children?" "Yes, you are my children, you may be my children, but you are Brahman." So immediately we understand what is this person. She is such a person that to her everything is Brahman, inside and outside, and side by side we are all her children. We are all her children. So we wonder what she is. And you ask her what you are. He did not ask what you are. He asked what we are to you. You ask what you are. She has clearly replied this point also. One person asked her not what you are, but we see that all the Shaktis, that is Sita, went before Rama. So we see that the Shaktis go before the Lord. "How are you still living after Sri Ramakrishna?" She replied, "You know that Sri Ramakrishna wanted to establish the motherhood of God." We have to turn a little to Sri Ramakrishna at this point. Sri Ramakrishna preached harmony, we know. For him, all the forms of God or the formless God or the transcendent Brahman or the immanent Brahman, all were at his fingertips. And though his real harmony stands on the basis of Advaita Jnana, and yet as a sthayi bhava, as a stable bhava of his life. He had adopted Kali the mother. He had adopted the mother-son attitude because that is what he thought. That is the nearest way to call upon God. All forms are correct. Whether God is my child or my friend or my husband or my wife or anything, that is all correct. But for this peace in this world, he thought that let God be called the mother, and that is what we say. Some of the people, you may call them ignorant or whatever you like, Bengalis and all the world over, in UP or Maharashtra or everywhere, some people still think he was a Kali's worshipper. That may be a very poor judgment, but the reason for the judgment is that that is what he adopted as his permanent bhav in this life. And so he wanted that we should feel God is our mother. And that is what mother said. He wanted to establish the motherhood of God, remember. And that is why he kept me behind. Do you understand now? God as mother of all. So when we say, our mother says, you are my children, or we feel she is our mother, don't take her like the worldly mother. Don't take her only as she has herself said, not mother which you accepted as mother. Maniwe mani, not maniwe ma, God as our mother. On this point I want to tell you, I have tried in my own mind and my life, whatever adjective or characteristics we talk of God, when I say God, I mean Saguna Brahma. He is the Srishti Siti Pralayakarta. He is what he is and what he is not. He is the Karunakara. Everything that we, and the main point is that he is self-willed person. If there is one self-willed person in this whole world, it is only God. We may cry and shout and he will do what he thinks right for us. We do not understand ourselves. We do not understand what is good for us. So God will not accept every demand of ours. Only when he thinks that is proper for us, he will do that. Self-willed person. In Bengali there is a beautiful song, Ichha mai tara tumi, tumar karma tumi karoma, loke bole kori ami. Shakali tumar ichha, ichha mai tara tumi. This song applies more than 100% to Sarada Devi. Everything we refer as God, she knows. She is the antaryami of all of us. She is what and what not. She is a doctor, do you know that point? One of the best doctors in this world. I have my own experience. You know, I lived alone in Rishikesh for almost 10 years, more than 8 years. And when I came to know, people used to wonder, what will you do for medical problems? I said, I don't have any worry about that. I told mother, mother, if I have to live here longer, you must see that my health remains all right. Now I started telling about myself, but what can I do? Whenever physical problem arose, medical problem, I used to tell mother, mother, this is my problem. And in three different ways she treated me, three different ways. Sometimes she would immediately cure me without any effort. If I complained to mother, she would cure me herself. Sometimes she would suggest the medicine, child, this is the medicine. And sometimes she would tell me, phone that doctor, he will tell. In these three ways she solved my problems. Anyway, but she was a wonderful doctor. I wrongly said was. She is a wonderful doctor. That is my main point. Don't associate any past tense when we think of Thakur or mother. You know what Mahapurusha Maharaj has said? Mahapurusha Maharaj said that in this world, everything comes and goes. Everything in this world comes and goes away. And the Brahman of the Vedantis neither comes nor goes. But there is something in the world which comes but does not go, Rishi Vakya. And what is that? Avatar. Incarnations come to the world, they do not go, they always remain. Even today people have the darshan of Rama or Krishna or Ramakrishna or Jesus or Buddha. So they do not give up that form. Only the sthool sharir drops. They never go away. And today mother is guiding many people. Those who are little meditative in their life, that seems to be the condition. But even beyond that also, when anybody is in trouble, she tells, I was talking of medical thing, but she solves the spiritual problems, she solves the philosophical problems, and she teaches Vedanta in the Vedantic language. That was little too much for me to first to understand. I will give an illustration. There is a sannyasini in Rishikesh. And, well, she used to attend my Vedanta classes there. But somehow I thought that she will appreciate these things. Being a Gujarati, that sannyasini, I called from Rajkot our main books and gave to her. Immediately she came in touch with Holy Mother through her meditation. And one day she asked, several things have happened. One day she asked, Mother, will you teach me what is this Adhyasa? Mother immediately replied, my child, the whole world is Adhyasa. Then next day perhaps or after some time she asked, Mother, will you please explain this Adhyasa more to me? She said, one should never think of Adhyastha, one should always think of Adhishthan. So in the Vedantic terms, you understand, Adhishthan is Brahman, on which all the Adhyasa is there. World is an Adhyasa on Brahman. So Mother said, one should not think of the Adhyastha, one should think only of the Adhishthan. Think only of Brahman, don't think of this world. So, Vedantic terms, so many things are happening today. So many things are happening today. Many people are there who are being guided by Mother. They see the Mother, they feel her in the meditative stage. Sometimes she may enter our dreams. Sometimes she may instruct us in the waking state. So what she is? God as our Mother. Some people say that God is, Sarada Devi is Mother, she is Guru, she is God. We cannot separate these things. We cannot separate. Can we dissect a person like that? But we know that she is God. Simultaneously, she is our Guru. She is our guide. She is our friend. In every difficulty or non-difficulty, she is always there. Never absent from our life. Once she graces her and catches her, now I come to some Pratyakshadarshi, living description of Holy Mother. Now, up till now I have told the living descriptions, but more vivid, let me start with an anecdote or whatever you like. And the name of the person, very, very holy to me, my Guruji, revered Swami Bhaskarashwaranandji. But I am talking of him when he was Vipradas Mukherjee, living in Gustegram, which is 3 kilometers away from Barasat, Mahapuruji's place. Now his mother, Shanti Mukherjee, was Holy Mother's initiated disciple. And both, mother and this youngest son, he had 2 elder brothers who were very worldly. But this mother and her youngest son, they were both great sadhakas. Even from primary school, he was meditative and lover of God. There were the 2 forces at his command, meditation and love. And mother would wake up the child, son, at 3 o'clock every day. And both used to meditate. Now his father had passed away. He was a rich man, he was a big advocate, and he had a lot of money. Other than the house in the village, he had a house in Calcutta also. And there his 2 elder brothers lived. And it was a male-dominated society. His mother had no independent existence in Calcutta. But in village she was her master. So she thought always that up to matriculation that boy has to study in the village. There was a high school there. But when he comes for college education to Calcutta, I will take him to the Holy Mother. That was her thought. And then he came. He was born in 1897, 1st June. So he came in the year 1914, at the age of 17, after passing matriculation, he came to Calcutta. Now the mother is telling, come my child with Holy Mother. He is not ready to accept at all. He had that young age vairagya, tremendous vairagya. I don't want to see any woman. I don't want to see the face of a woman. She was so much pestering. My child, it is not a woman. Do you not understand her godhood? She is goddess. He said, no, 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 I don't want to see any woman. Then she said, as a last resort, my child, for my sake you come once. After that I will not press you again. You and your luck, you and how the mother deals with you, for my sake, plus once you come there. That under this pretext he agreed. So mother and son go to Udbodhan. You know, in Calcutta, Mayerwadi, it has two names. Udbodhan means it is the Bengali publication office of the Ramakrishna Mission on the ground floor. And first floor is for Holy Mother. So it is called Mayerwadi also. So both of them went to Mayerwadi and she did not take him with her to Holy Mother. She wanted that independently they should meet and find out. So she sat with Saradhan Swamiji on the ground floor and instructed him, go upstairs, go to such a room, and this much she told him, tell him in my name that I am Shantir Chele Eshechi. I am Shanti's son, I have come to you. Now he goes to that room, indicated room, and comes back. And the mother asks, what happened? He said, I did not see anybody there. I didn't find Holy Mother there. She said, you must have gone to a wrong room. Why should I go to a wrong room? I went to the room as you have told me. You go once more. Why should I go once more when there is nobody there? When they were, mother and son were quarreling like this, Saradhan Swamiji was smiling. And then Saradhan Swamiji intervened and said, my boy, you went to that room. Yes, Maharaj. What did you see there? He was telling, nobody is there. Saradhan Swamiji is asking, my boy, what did you see there? He said, there is a cot there and one sadi is lying helter-skelter. One sadi is lying helter-skelter on that cot. You understand this? Holy Mother used to cover herself so much, she never saw any point of her body. A sadi is lying helter-skelter. Saradhan Swamiji says, my boy, you have seen that sadi? In that sadi, my boy, Holy Mother is virajita. I can't translate in English this. Shining, glorying, shining you may say, virajita. My boy, in that very sadi, my is virajita. And he says, in a moment my consciousness was transformed. Rishi Vakya is to create Rishi Vakya. Of course the bhumi has to be there. He said, the moment he said virajita, immediately it struck me, nobody calls a man virajita, it is only Devi, he is a goddess, there he is talking virajita. And he became so much thrilled, he was so much happy in his life, that, oh, I will be seeing a Devi. But then the problem, he did not see her at all. So Saradhan Swamiji says, my boy, go to that room again. And when you see the sadi, put your eyes on that sadi. And along with the sadi, bring your eyes down. And when you will find the sadi touching the ground, you will find the two toes projecting. That much mother used to cover. His mother is telling again and again, go again. He says, why should I go? But when Saradhan Swamiji told him, in that very sadi which you saw, Holy Mother is virajita, is shining. And then the point came in his mind that, oh, but how can I see her? He didn't ask. But Saradhan Swamiji told him, go again, my boy, see that sadi, and along with that sadi, bring your eyes down. Like that he is describing. And when you see the sadi is touching the ground, there you will find the two big toes projecting. Then he was very much thrilled. I will see the Devi. I will see the Devi's thumbs. He went up again. And as he instructed, he looked at that sari and he brought his eyes down as he was instructing. And when he saw the two big toes projected, he felt so much thrilled. But the thing came in his mind, oh, I have seen the Devi's thumbs, Devi's toes. Shall I not see her face? In the meanwhile, as his mother had instructed him, he said, Mother, I am Shantir Chele Eshichi. I am Shanti's son, I have come. And the moment he uttered these words, Holy Mother removed her veil totally. He got it as a reply, not to his words, in his mind, that he desired to see her face, and she showed her face. And he was so much thrilled, oh, this is how Devi looks. Before completing the story, I want to put one more sentence here. We read in the books and we hear from many people, it was difficult to recognize the Holy Mother. From my Guruji, I never heard it even once. He did not recognize her so long as he had not seen her, so long as his mother was telling him. But the moment Saradhan Swamiji told Devi, he never could not misunderstand her, always saw her as a Devi. Anyway, so when he thought, shall I not see the Devi's face? She dropped the veil completely. And then the aspiration, even it cannot be called ambition, spiritual aspiration rose higher. And he thought, oh, that is how Devi looks. But shall I not listen her words, how the Devi speaks? And the moment he thought Devi, how the Devi speaks, the Devi spoke to him. Because from outside we will see response to his what he talked. Shantir Chele Eshichi. Oh, you have come, my boy. Good. Bhalo. Eshicho, bhalo korecho. So he heard her words. But then again, something spiritual desire rose in him. How the Devi walks, I want to see. And she got up and walked in front of him and went to the inner room in front of him. Very natural from her side, but his every aspiration is being fulfilled. And she came back in a plate. In Bengali we say luchi sandesh. That is, luchi is like puri made of maida. And sandesh is a Bengali sweet. So she saw in a plate she brought luchi and sandesh and told him, my boy, Thakur's prasad, you please eat. Now he started eating of great joy, but a thought is lingering in his mind. It was difficult for us to visualize today, those days Bengal culture. If you go to anybody's house and whatever is given, if you eat completely, you are asabhya. You are too much, you want to eat too many things, or they have not given you sufficiently. So the custom and the culture of Bengal in those days was that if anything is given to you, you must leave something in the plate, uneaten. These days it is difficult to believe this. So the thought comes to his mind, Thakur's prasad, Devi Mother herself has given me, and I have to leave here also. Only thought came. And she said, my boy, here nothing has to be left. You eat everything. Don't leave anything in the plate. Now this incident happened in 1914, I told you. And he left his body in 1976. And up to 1976, January he left his body. Up to 1975, Holy Mother's birthday, Up to 1975, we have heard this incident from him any number of times. And every time, as if yesterday only he has visited her, so fresh this incident was in his life. Now I will digress a little rather, and tell you that whoever has been to Holy Mother, that experience is unforgettable always. I am telling one incident from the book. There was a great personality in the matter of cinema. Movie, when it was called movie, it was not talkie, silent cinema. Sourabh Modi from Mumbai, Parsi gentleman, for what he came to Calcutta and how he knew about Holy Mother. She was not much known in those days, but he went to Udbodhan and said, I want to have darshan of Mother. Seeing a Parsi coming from such a great distance, Sardan Swamiji asked the Brahmachari. Mother was not physically well in those days, so the darshan and everything was restricted. But Sardan Swamiji told, you take him, let him make pranam to Mother. And as soon as he went there, he said, Mai ji, aisa kuch mool mantra dijiye jisse khuda ko pehchana jaye. Please give me some mantra by which I can recognize God, pehchana jaye. And she said, shall I give him? The Brahmachari resisted because she was not well physically. He said, what will Maharaj say? She said, go and ask Maharaj about it. The Brahmachari left him there and came back to Maharaj. And Maharaj said, if Mother wants a Parsi son, how can I object? And when he went back, he saw Mother has already made two asanas ready and everything. Now, I don't want not started describing this, but when I was in Mumbai, I had not met Sourabh Modi, but head of our ashram was Swami Niramayanji, and we have a hospital there. And this Sourabh Modi is such a big man, rich man or whatever you may say, for every small physical difficulty, he would come to our hospital, a mission hospital in Mumbai. So he was admitted. For 3-4 days he was there. Niramanji used to talk to him. And Niramanji asked about this incident, because this is in the book. And he said, yes, Maharaj, it is so fresh in my mind. So many things have happened in my life up and down, but that incident is so fresh in my mind. Even today I feel as if yesterday only she has initiated me. So the Mother's impression is so fresh always in everybody's mind. And so our Maharaj has talked about this to us any number of times. And still, so from one Rishi, he understood as a very ordinary word. He realized that devihood of Mother. Now we refer to another Rishi, and that is Mahapurush Maharaj, Swami Shivanandaji. Now it was a custom in those days, every now and then, that after Arati, evening Arati, generally people used to go to Mahapurush Maharaj's room to salute him, and if he talks something, to listen to that, to ask him something like that. Now Swami Ekanda's disciple, she does not like to call herself a disciple. She used to say, I am Swami Ekanda's friend, Josephine MacLeod. And Josephine MacLeod from America had come to India, and she was staying in Belur Mutt guest house, what is called the foreign guest house. And she also came, and after Arati, she is about to enter Mahapurji's room, and Mahapurji stops her. MacLeod, I tell you, first salute Sri Ram Krishna and then come here. Now it was a well-known fact that if somebody went to Mahapurji's room without going to the temple, he did not like that. And that was known to MacLeod well. So she said, Maharaj, I have just now visited the shrine and now I am coming to you. So she wanted again to step, I again stop. MacLeod, I tell you, take a boat, cross the Ganges, go to Udbodhan, salute Sri Ram Krishna first and then come to me. And she was charged by what he saw. She has seen, with the Swami Ekanda's help, she has seen Holy Mother many times. But Mahapuruji is telling her, go to Udbodhan and salute Sri Ramakrishna and then come to me. So she became charged. This much is in the books also. She became charged and coming down, she is asking Brahmacharis, please get a boat for me, I want to go to Udbodhan. And when she came back, she was walking on the Ganges parapet of Belur Math for a long time. I have seen her. All this is in the books. But I want to tell you the other part which is not in the books. This very boy, Vipradas Mukherjee, or he was a sadhu at that time, I can't say correctly. He was also there. And he asked Mahapurush Maharaj, after MacLeod went, he asked Mahapurush Maharaj, Maharaj, what have you said this? We know that mother lives there and you are telling, salute Sri Ramakrishna first. He said, my boy, do you not know what is Thakur is mother? What is mother is Thakur? Then the boy said, what did you say? No, it may be in the books. But are you telling me the highest philosophy or are you telling me your experience? He said, my boy, that is the highest philosophy and that is my own experience. What is Thakur is Ma, what is Ma is Thakur. So, one rishi showed him mother's devitva. The other rishi told him identity between Thakur and Ma. Now, some more funny coincidence is coming to my mind that Thakur worshipped Ma on Phalaharini Kali Puja day, Phalaharini Kali Puja night rather, and there their identity was established, that you know. And this boy whom I am talking about, Vipradas Mukherjee, was born on the Phalaharini Kali Puja day. Not that day, huh? Much afterwards, but that particular day. Anyway, so through him we could see the identity always, never too. I remember another incident. Some great sadhu is telling me, what is your idea about Sri Ramakrishna? I said, to me he is Parabrahman. What is your idea about Holy Mother? I said, for me there is no difference. She is Parabrahman. Then that senior sadhu wanted to teach me, you know, like fire and its daika shakti, there I could never enter it my mind. Because I have been imbued with this concept continuously that there is no difference. One reality appearing in two forms. In this Kali Yuga, it was so much necessary. Thakur showed everything in his life. All the sadhanas he has shown. He has shown even the women's sadhana. We know Dasi Bhava, Madhur Bhava, everything she has shown. But could he have shown how a woman lives in this world? Could he have shown how an ideal husband and wife should live in this world? For that and for many other things, just now as I told you, to establish motherhood of God, it was necessary that he should have a partner, that he should have another form of the reality with him. Then only they could enact this. Sarjan Swamiji has said in the Great Master, though it has never come out, he has said that if God wishes, if I have energy and drive, I could write about the relation between the Thakur and mother, but it has never come about, except whatever we get in the Leela Prasanga, the Great Master. This relation between Thakur and mother is a subject of meditation only. And if you can rightly meditate on this topic, the relation between Thakur and mother, will enter Nirvikalpa Samadhi, mind you. That is their relation. Their relation is not in this world at all. So, through Shivananda Swami, we understand through this parampara the absolute identity between Thakur and Ma. Now, in this regard, though the thing is past, but I feel it is my duty to point out something. The question comes, When this boy understood mother's devihood and identity with Thakur, why he did not, what should I, the word used, why was he not initiated by the Holy Mother? And in this regard, excuse me if I tell the name, because it has come in print. In Vedanta Kasri, you know, between articles, some small snippets are given, long back. And in the name of Swami Satsurupananji, revered Swami Satsurupananji, it has been written that this boy had such a vairagya that he did not get mantra from a woman. And he says, Satsurupananji, we were deluded and we took our mantra. This is an insult to both mother and my Guruji. The real reason is different. And Satsurupananji told this to us also in Nagpur. We never contradicted him. How to contradict any revered person? But now I am telling you, because that thing appeared in Vedanta Kesari, so I am bound to tell you. Mother knows the past of everybody. Mother knows the relation between Mahapuruji and this boy is long back an eternal relation. She sent him to Mahapurush Maharaj. And little digressing from mother, but this point is important. He had received initiation in dream from Mahapurush Maharaj. Even his mother did not know. And when the Holy Mother's body was on the pyre, his mother is telling him, see my boy, I used to tell you, now you have to repent. You have not taken initiation from her. He could never reveal this. It was revealed only when Mahapurush Maharaj was about to give sannyas to him. Then somebody said he is not initiated. He went to Koka Maharaj. Koka Maharaj told him, go to Mahapurush Maharaj. And he said, Maharaj, people are talking like this. He said, what do you say? Have I not initiated you? In such and such year? In such and such place? Then he said, yes, Maharaj. No, he said, I don't believe that Ganjadi. Dream initiation, he calls effect of ganja, hemp. Then Mahapurush Maharaj is not disturbed. Okay, sit down, I will tell you the mantra now. And when he told him the mantra, then he caught his feet and said, Maharaj, yes, I received this and I have been doing this. Now this thing was known to Holy Mother. Holy Mother knows our past, present and future. Swami Ekanda has told, who is your guru? One who knows your past, present and future. So, mother sent him to, now in this, now I will tell you one more thing here. In those days, Mahapurush Maharaj was not giving initiation from outside. Holy Mother was giving initiation and Brahman Swamiji was giving initiation. So some disciple approaches Mahapurush Maharaj and says, Maharaj, is there any difference? Some people take initiation from mother, some people take initiation from Brahmanji. Is there any difference? Mahapuruji said, why should there be any difference? The rain water falls on the terrace. And on the terrace, some tiger mouth, some cow's mouth, and the water comes from different mouths. But the same rain water comes. Why there should be difference? And then after a reply, he says, but my child, your question was wrong. You asked me, somebody take initiation from mother, somebody. Nobody can take initiation from anybody. They get initiation. They get initiation from Holy Mother. Some people get their initiation from Maharaj. Don't say they take initiation. We have to understand this point also. So, Holy Mother could have herself said, you take initiation. Anyway, now come back to the main story. Now, because this one point has appeared in print, I take it as my bounden duty to clear this misunderstanding. Now what she taught him, now I am going in this line, first person line, not my first person, first person line from my Guruji. Now I told you that the same thing is called Mayer body and it is called Udbodhan. So on the ground floor is the Bengali publication department of the Ramakrishna Mission. And in those days, Swami Vivekananda's lectures on Jnana Yoga, revered Swami Shuddhananji had translated in Bengali, and they were getting printed in the Bengali Jnana Yoga. And seeing a brilliant college boy, Shuddhananji asked him, "Will you help us in reading the proofs? I think all of you are aware that there is something called proof reading. No book or no matter, even the computer days, cannot be printed directly. 2-3 times it has to be corrected. Then only it goes to print." So seeing a good boy, Shuddhananji asked him to help in proofreading. He said, "Yes, Maharaj." And this he did not tell Holy Mother. There were two different things in his life. Going to Mother for spiritual, he continued going to both Mother and Mahapurush Maharaj. But that was a different aspect, and this is a good work, and he is able to read Swamiji's works also. So he accepted that. He did not tell it to Holy Mother. But she came to know. And one day when he came to proofread, the message was there that when the boy comes to read proofs, send him to me. So very happily he went that Mother herself has called me. And she goes and said, "Mother, you called me?" Mother said, "Yes, I heard that you are reading proof these days." She said, "Yes, Mother." Mother said, "Shall I teach you how to read proofs?" This was another thrill to him. Mother is going to teach how to read proofs. "Yes, Mother, please tell me." She said, "As soon as you come, don't start work. Sit quiet. See Thakur in your heart. Pray to him earnestly to make you his instrument. And Thakur, please make me your instrument. And as your instrument, I will do this work." And then with this feeling, with this bhava, start proofreading. And always there is a pause in every work. So whenever there is a pause, see that Thakur is sitting in your heart. And when you complete proofreading, don't abruptly go to your house. See Thakur in your heart. Offer the work done that day to Thakur. Offer the fruits thereof to Thakur. And offer yourself to Thakur. And then, thinking of Thakur, gradually, slowly, you go to your house. "Go, my boy, go and read proofs." Now, I have so many teachers. So one of my teachers used to say, "Is this true only about proofreading? Is it not applicable to every work?" Especially talking to women, he used to say, "Is it not true for your roti, your rolling breads? Is it Thakur not present in the atta? Is Thakur not present in the chakla belan? Rolling pin and rolling board everywhere, and Thakur not present in the hearts of those who are eating, going to eat this? With this awareness you should do your work." So this is a great lesson Mother taught him. And this also we used to hear so many times from him. Because the thing, once Mother takes us, everything becomes so fresh in our mind, never becomes old. Now, about myself, I was in Rishikesh for 8.5 years, all of you know perhaps. Now, till then, I had not come in direct touch with Holy Mother. There was a Gujarati sannyasini. And she used to attend my Vedanta classes. But somehow I felt that she is fit enough to understand Thakur and Mother. So I called books from our Rajkot ashram. Complete works of Swamiji and Leela Prasanga and Holy Mothers, and I gave to her. She was a great meditator. So, reading those books, she immediately came in touch with Holy Mother in her meditation. Now, I was living in Ramakrishna Mission, Ramakrishna Mutt Kutir, in Mayakuni in Rishikesh. And this ashrama was very near. Our ashram may be 150 meters hardly. And there used to have discourse twice a day. But many people did not know, even some of our Swamis do not know that we have a kutiya in Rishikesh. Some people felt some private ashram are, so people are not aware from where I come and give this discourse. So this was a little question in the mind of that sannyasini. Now in the midnight, Holy Mother woke her up. How to know it was Mother? Now, I have to tell something personal here. My pre-monastic name is Sharad. And Mother, you know, never took the monastic name, never in her life. They are all revered Swamis for her. She would take the pre-monastic name only. So in the midnight, Mother wakes up this lady, this sannyasini, and says, do you know where my Sharad lives? There is no private thing. That is Ramakrishna Mission Kutiya. And he is doing special work of Thakur here. And when that work will be over, he will be moved from here. Now, incident I am not describing for myself. From this incident, I came to understand so many things. And some of my friends here, person who has arranged all these talks, Sudhir Maharaj. When I told this to him, he was so happy. You know what I am telling? Holy Mother runs not only the whole world, Holy Mother runs in a special way the Ramakrishna Mission. And later on somebody told me, and I had to accept that, she runs the Sarada Mutha also. And what about these great people? The General Secretary and the Administrative and all that, they are puppets. The whole organization is run by Holy Mother. Not only she knows everything, she runs everything. And this I learned from that. That it is Ramakrishna Mission Kutiya. He has been brought here for some special work. And when that work will be over, he will be moved from there. Understand now? So, how much time is going on? Oh, anyway. And all this, in those days at least. The difference between those days and these days is that she had a physical body. And the physical body was getting old and old and old. And she has taken up the sins of so many people. We know Thakur took sins of some people and suffered from cancer. Holy Mother suffered from Kala Azar, incurable. And Swami Ekanda instructed this thing to all the brother disciples. The special incident is about Swami Vigyanandanji. Generally he used to keep away from women in those days. So Swamiji asked him one day, have you made pranams to Holy Mother? He said, no, go, now go and make pranams to her. Now he thought he will go and just bow down and come out. He did not know Swamiji followed with him. And when he put his head, don't know, not like that. Make dandavat pranam, flat pranam, full. But don't touch her feet. And he instructed all those who were around, we should not touch her feet. She is so compassionate that even by looking at us, she takes up our sins. But if you touch her feet, so much it becomes trouble to her. You know, she continuously used to wash her feet with Ganges water. Jala koche, it is burning. Because everybody's sin she was accepting. You cannot imagine this thing. And when she was asked about it, why Mother you are doing all this? She said, Amraki Rasgulakete Eshi Chishudu. Have we come only to enjoy good things of life here? We have come to take people's sins. who have to come to release them. And about her mantra diksha, all of you know, it was giving mukti. She used to say, when I give a mantra, I have given him mukti. If you want jivan mukti, you have to struggle spiritually to realize in your life. Otherwise, you are never to come back. Mukti I have already given to you. So much compassionate. That is the difference between, now we cannot say Thakur is not compassionate. Rather, Thakur's compassion comes to us in the form of Holy Mother. Now I'll tell you, some of my friends, some of our Swamis give some wrong instructions. Some sadhakas, both Swamis, I know many Swamis like that, and some householders, men and women, they have got Thakur's mantra and they are meditating on Thakur, but they see Holy Mother. And when they approach some of our senior Swamis, they tell, no, you should not digress. Remove that from your mind. Think of Thakur. It is very wrong. Thakur comes to us. Thakur's grace comes to us as Holy Mother. They are not different, I already told you. Now there is a story in Kenopanishad, and that story is being reenacted again. You know the Kenopanishad story? Brahman won the war on behalf of gods, the war between Devas and Asuras. And in that victory, gods thought they are glorious, they are their victory. And to remove their ego, because then they will become Asuras like that. So, Brahman came to know of this idea of theirs, and he appeared where they were sitting and congratulating each other. In front of them, he came in a wonderful form, yaksha form. And they could not understand what he is. So they told Agni Devata, you go and find out who he is. He said, yes, I will do it. And immediately he went there. And going there, he became stunned. He could not speak a word. That yaksha is asking Agni, who are you? No, he says, I am Agni. I am Jataveda, know everything. So he tells his degree also. And that yaksha ignored that. Okay, you are Agni, you are Jataveda, but what do you do? He said, I can burn the whole world. Then he puts a little straw before him. Burn this. And he jumps on it with all his power, but he could not burn it. Because the power belongs to God. He has given to us. It is not ours. He did not tell what has happened. He comes back and says, I could not find who he is. They send Vayu. Vayu went there. And he became stunned. Yaksha asked Vayu, what is your name? He said, I am Vayu, I am Matarishwa. That means I feel the whole universe. Okay, you are Vayu, you are Matarishwa, but what do you do? I can blow away the whole world. He says, blow away this small straw. He could not do it. He also came back. Then the gods told their king Indra, now you have to go. We are not unable to find out. The moment Indra went there, that yaksha disappeared. But Indra did not come back. If he had more ego, he had more responsibility. And he stood there introspecting himself. What mistake happens from my side? Because I saw him talking to Agni and Vayu, and to me he did not talk even. He went away. And so, he continued being there, thinking of him. And then what happened? Uma Haimavati, one beautiful woman appeared there. That is how the scriptures describe it. More beautiful than the whole world. Shankar says, Brahma Vidya is always beautiful. Or if you take literally Uma Haimavati, Himalayas Kanya Uma, then Shankar says, because she always lives with Shiva, so she knows everything. And seeing the woman, rather seeing the mother, Indra felt little assured and asked her, who he was, mother? She said, that was Brahman. And it was Brahman who has won the war, not you. And then Indra came to know that it was Brahman. From Indra, the Vayu and Agni came to know, all the gods came to know. This is being enacted again. What Sri Ramakrishna has told about her, Now the difference is that she is described as Uma Hemavati, and here we find her Sarada Saraswati. I don't think there is any difference in that. So, form may be different. Sri Ramakrishna has said she is Sarada, she is my Shakti, she is Sarada, and she has come to give knowledge. So, same scene is repeated. So, Holy Mother comes as Sri Ramakrishna's concrete grace. That is how the Holy Mother comes to us. Sudhir Maharaj, shall I continue 5-10 minutes more? He is not speaking. I will continue. So, now let me tell about myself. Let me tell about myself now. I have to tell you a little about my sadhana. And I think while talking about Vedanta and Buddhism one day, I told that I am a Buddhistic Vedanti. Okay, please quiet. Please stop the other mics.
Maharaj, just 1 minute, Maharaj.
Yes.
Maharaj, you can continue for another half an hour, Maharaj. Absolutely no problem. Please go ahead.
No, so much I don't want to. Just I want to complete this why I am taken.
Please take the freedom, Maharaj. Okay. Please take the freedom.
Sir, my sadhana in Rishikesh was imagining or visualizing what you would like to call that I have burnt a fire, bonfire. And whatever is called I am not talking of body and all that. In my mind, whatever is called I used to cut it into pieces and throw in that fire. That was my sadhana. But one day I was feeling so much pain that still I is not gone completely. So much I have burned, but still I has not gone completely, like that pain I was feeling. And Mother spoke to me very clearly. To say I saw Mother will not be right. To say I did not see Mother will not be right. Because with these eyes I did not see. But I felt her sitting just on my right side. But she spoke and the word was very clear. And she said there is nothing in Bengali. তুই বলে কিছু নাই আমার হাতের একটা যন্ত্র দের ইজ নথিং কল্ড ইউ ওনলি দের ইজ অ্যান ইনস্ট্রুমেন্ট ইন মাই হ্যান্ড নাও টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দিস ইনস্ট্রুমেন্ট টেক্স টাইম আফটার সাম টাইম উইদিন এ উইক অর মে বি উইদিন ওয়ান অর টু ডেজ সমথিং হ্যাপেন্ড And Mother said, today a big thing has been done. I asked her, Mother, what is the next thing I have to do? And then came the immortal words in Bengali. Kori to ami. You understand? It is I who do. That point I understood what is instrument. It is not Das Bhav. Das has his own will. Kori to ami, it is I who do, you are an instrument, so you have no right to ask me what is the next work you have to do. You have no right to feel happy or miserable for anything, you are just an instrument. And that has made my mind free, totally free. Anyway, I know, I have not realized God. Please do not misunderstand, I am not bragging. I am not a Brahmajna, not at all. But I know I am Holy Mother's instrument. And that has made my mind totally free. I am not worried where I will take my next food. I am not worried where I will live. Anyway, so I don't want to proceed much further. Let me see what your points came to me. Everything, I told you, that everything we relate, I make this difference. There is no difference I know, but I make this difference. Everything that we associated as Ishvara or Saguna Brahma, Mother comes to my mind. And when I think of Nirguna Brahma, then Thakur comes to my mind. He sits in Samadhi always. He helps us. When a person is intent to go to a Nirvikalpa Samadhi, Thakur helps us. But for all, every other matter, it is Mother who helps us. And Mother runs these institutions. I told you just now, when I told this to Sudhir Maharaj, he was so, so happy. Anyway, I think, friends, it was the greatest day of my life. Today I spoke about her a little in Hindi, in Khetri Ashram in the morning. Little, 35 minutes. Now, I think I poured my heart out. That day, in Thakur's day, I said it is the greatest moment of my life, but I feel so damn happy today. I have been able to share with all of you what I felt about the... It is impossible to describe, Mother. Impossible. You go on talking about her days and days and nights, but what was too much personal for me, I have been able to express. And I have been able to express in a living language from people who have seen her at near, people who never said that difficult to understand her. On this difficult matter, let me tell one incident. Some people said, Mother, how to understand you? You live like a very ordinary woman. She said, bring me another ordinary woman like me. Bring me one more ordinary woman like me. You understand? Being ordinary is the most difficult thing in life. Being ordinary is the most difficult thing in life. Everybody thinks some anyway. So she said, bring me one more ordinary woman like me. Her greatness lies in her ordinariness. Her greatness lies in absorbing all spirituality and behaving like a common woman. Enough for the day, friends. Om Brahmani Brahma Shaktyanscha Abheda Paramarthata Tathapi Karuna Kara Sarada Gyanadayini Jananim Saradam Devim Ramakrishnam Jagadgurum Padapadme Tayo Shritva Pranamami Murmuhu Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Sarada Charanarpanamastu Shri Ramakrishnarpanamastu.